And good evening. Welcome to the Stan Watson Show. I'm your host, Stan Watson. Thank you again for tuning into our show. Joined again by my lovely co-host who took over last week, I understand, Samantha Caldwell. How are you today?
Not take over.
I heard about this. I know.
No, we missed you, really.
Right. I heard it was a corporate takeover. But I'm back tonight. I still own 51% of the shares in the company, so I'm ready to go. We have a great show tonight.
Yes,
we're going to take a quick break and come back. And our first guest is going to be our solicitor of DeKalb County, that's Sherry Boston. If we stay right there, I promise you, Samantha and I will be right back.
Hello, I'm DeKalb County Interim CEO Lee May, and I'm excited to announce after a successful test run, we are rolling forward to one. It's one of the biggest service delivery changes in our county's history, all to better serve you.
Starting July 6th, DeKalb's implementing a one-day-a-week service model for collecting your garbage, recycling, and yard trimmings. We are rolling forward with the times to reduce inefficiencies, keep costs low, and improve safety. It's a change for the county, but a necessary one. The new program offers many benefits with absolutely no increase in fees to you. The county will provide standardized 65-gallon green trash containers, which will create a streamlined look of uniformity in your neighborhood. You'll place your solid waste, recycling, and yard trimmings at the curb all on the same day now. That's once a week. Rolling forward to one also includes an increased focus on recycling education and litter reduction, falling right in line with DeKalb's many green initiatives. This new program is expected to save the county between $8 to $10 million annually. Part of those savings will come from lower costs for equipment, maintenance, and resources. Also, no sanitation division employees will be terminated as a result of this service level change. Some employees will be redeployed to serve in varying roles with the division's Clean Communities Initiative, thereby keeping our communities even cleaner than ever before. If you have any questions about the new sanitation collection procedures, contact customer service at 404-294-2900 or go online to rollingforwardto1.com.
So, get ready for Rolling Forward to One as this new program saves time, money, and resources. DeKalb County, it's time to roll, and we are doing it together as one.
And we're back, and thank you again for tuning in to the Stan Watson Show. I'm your host, Stan Watson, along with my lovely co-host, Samantha Caldwell. You ready to go to work?
I'm ready to rock and roll.
Let's do it. Our first guest is Sherry Boston. She's Solicitor General for DeKalb County. Welcome to the Stan Watson Show.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. Thank you, Samantha.
This has been your, third time, I think.
I know. Thank you so much for having me back.
Good. Now, for the people that don't know, tell us what a Solicitor General does at the local level.
Well, your Solicitor General is responsible for the prosecution of all misdemeanor cases in DeKalb County. So we handle everything from your misdemeanor crimes to code enforcement to traffic, and I like to say my quality of life crimes, keeping people understanding that we want to make DeKalb County the best place to live, work, and play.
I like that. DeKalb County, you hear that? The best place to live, work, and play? I like it. She's in another county, but we won't talk about it. We'll keep it in DeKalb. Also, you've been doing a lot of work in the community. I know you had something with a canned food drive, and you also do a little bit with, we call it domestic violence. Talk a little bit about your task force and those things you've been doing.
Well, we are so happy that we were hosted the fifth annual Domestic Violence Symposium just last month.
That's right.
For the fifth time, we were able to bring everybody into DeKalb to talk about coordinating a community response to domestic violence. We were able to air that event live. We had tweeting. We had lots of guests to speak on all legal issues to help engage the community. And I'm really proud of that event because we have actually had victims that have come into that event because they knew they could get help and helped them out, and then they went back and we followed them a year later. And this year we had April Ross, whose story was covered exclusively in Atlanta. She's well known, her family is well known in Atlanta, and unfortunately she was a victim in a very horrific domestic violence incident in the last 18 months left her paralyzed. And she was our speaker this year, our survivor. and the folks really enjoyed hearing her talk about her story and how it played out very publicly in the media. Because people knew who she was, they knew who her family was. So when she was shot, it became the number one news story. It's hard for those of us that experience hard things in our life, but that for that to play out on television, it takes it to a whole nother level.
But she does a lot. You do a lot of things in the community. You, you did a canathon once. Talk a little bit about that. She's not the normal, you know, Solicitor General.
She's in the
doing some other things.
Yeah. Well, I believe it's my responsibility to bring awareness to certain issues that really affect our community because we want to stop things before they get to a criminal activity. I'm proud to be involved in Food Frenzy that we did with the with the Attorney General and the State Bar of Georgia. Our office took home an award for collecting more food than any other legal organization in the state for 2 years in a row. But the reason that's important is because we want to feed our children. We want them to have warm, full bellies when they go to school so that they can concentrate and get their education, because we know that 90% of the folks that are sitting over in DeKalb County Jail are without a GED and were without a high school equivalency. So we know there's a direct correlation between education and a life of crime. And we want to stop it and focus on that education so we don't have to prosecute later on in life.
It's powerful.
That's really powerful.
Yes, yes.
Wow, and you know, you hit upon a great point, and that is a community servant. It's more than just being on the back end of it, but getting in the trenches before those incidents happen to be more preventive and proactive than, you know, kind of coming on the other side where people see you behind.
Prevention is always good.
Absolutely.
Now, you're here tonight with us also to talk a little bit about an essay program. Talk a little bit about that. Who's involved? What's going on?
Well, this is wonderful. It's a new initiative, and I reached out to all my commissioners, and I'm happy to say that they all jumped right on board to our
new
initiative.
Did I jump on board?
You did.
Okay.
You did. I was
getting crazy. I was like, okay, did I do anything? Okay.
Yes, you did. And so it's called Creating a Safer DeKalb. And we're sponsoring a contest for eighth graders across DeKalb County. As long as you attend any school in DeKalb County, you're eligible to participate. And we're asking our eighth graders to write an essay about how, if they could maybe be CEO for the day, or a BOC member, or Solicitor General, or Chief of Police, how would you like to make DeKalb County safer? What would you do? We want kids to start thinking about life in the next level, that they can achieve whatever they want to do in their lives. And we want them to think about how they can be involved in their communities. And I'm really excited about this new partnership, and I'm excited to see how many of our eighth grade students across DeKalb are willing to jump in and submit essays for this contest.
Exciting.
So now, what's the criteria for how you're going to grade? I mean, that's a hard topic.
And that's a lot of students as well.
Well, it's a lot of students.
Eighth graders
in
middle
about
school. So that's a lot of schools.
Well, luckily, we decided to partner with, as I said, the county and the Board of Commissioners. And so we decided that we would award a student in every district.
I like that. I like that.
Every district. Because we think we have students all across the county, the north, the south, the east, and the west. That all represent the best of DeKalb.
That's right.
And so we wanted to make sure we recognized a student in every district. So
that's
are going to be having those submissions, dividing them up by the districts, and there will be a winner in every single district. And we've gotten partners that have agreed to donate our prizes.
Who are the partners?
Other lawyers in the community have reached out and
like
agreed.
Like the DeKalb Lawyers Association or people like
that? Individual lawyers and law firms that heard what we wanted to do and said that they'll donate. And our plan is to give a tablet to every one of our five winners. So that they can use that, take that for schoolwork, and apply the what they've learned from here, but so that they can have something to continue on in education and be excited about, especially going into high school. And we're going to give each of those students an opportunity, an event in the spring, to come and read their essays to all of our elected officials.
Now again, I may have missed it. How are we judging this now?
Well, we have a committee in our office, and I'm on it, and I'm committed to reading every single essay that comes in. We're going to enlist help from some other folks and try to narrow it down. But we're excited, and I hope that I'm hope that I have to read 400 or 500
yeah,
essays.
Yeah.
Bring it on.
That's a lot.
Bring it on. I hope I do.
But that's good if our young people could learn to write in this essay process. It's for a good cause, creating a safer DeKalb. I think that's going to be awesome.
Well, and it'll generate some great ideas, I'm sure.
I hope so. I hope to get the next great idea to enlist in my office, and I will gladly credit a DeKalb County student with that idea.
Right here in DeKalb County, Decide DeKalb. Well, that's a great Sherry. Thank you so much for coming by. She's our solicitor. If you have a general number that you may want to give to the general public if they're having problems with any other things that you cover in your office, you want to do that for us now?
Absolutely. Our main number is 404-371-2001. And that's our main number if anyone has questions or if you are a victim and you need assistance. You can always call that number.
Now, I got to do this before you go. When does the contest start? I got to make sure.
Well, we are going to coordinate with the schools and we're hoping to get the information out late this month or early December. And the students will have plenty of time to get their submissions in.
Excellent. Well, you heard it right here again on the Stan Watson Show. Our guest has been Sherry Boston, Solicitor General for DeKalb County. She is creating a program, essay program, that says to create a safer DeKalb. And so we look forward to helping you with that as well.
Yes.
Excellent. Well, guess what? We got to take a quick break because we got another guest coming up. But I hope that you stay right there. Samantha and I will be right back.
Cannot approve the loan until your wife goes back to work. I'm sorry.
Housing discrimination isn't always obvious or straightforward, but it is against the law. The U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development, HUD, protects your rights to equal opportunity in housing.
If you've experienced housing discrimination, HUD can help. They can pursue compensation for your injuries and protect your equal opportunity to housing free of discrimination.
Are you receiving phone calls from people you don't know who call you on the phone and call you by name? I'm DeKalb County Sheriff Jeff Mann, reminding everyone, especially senior citizens, to beware of potential scammers who call you on the phone and pretend to want to be your friend. My advice to you is to just hang up. Do not hold conversations with them. Do not give them any information about yourself, your living conditions, or your habits. If you find yourself talking to them, never agree to help them in any way. They are thieves and crooks, and their plan is to get you to trust them so they can take your hard-earned money. I'm DeKalb Sheriff Jeff Mann, and your safety is my priority.
I don't want another drinking man in my life. I want to feel more fulfilled. Does my happiness depend on whether someone else drinks? My pastor suggested I try Al-Anon family groups, and I'm glad I did. Are you troubled by someone else's drinking? You might be surprised at what you could learn in an Al-Anon family group from people just like you. Call 1-888-4-Al-Anon or go to alanon.org.
We're the stronger than we look type. The braver than you think type. The type that's sure the time will come when we put type 1 behind us. We're the progress is inevitable type. The rise to every challenge type. The type that knows bit by bit the future is certain to get better. We're the plan for a cure type. The improve life along the way type. The type that will stop at nothing. Absolutely nothing. Until type one becomes type none.
You say you'd give your right arm to be there for your family? Here's your chance to prove it. Have your blood pressure checked and control it to lower your risk of heart attack and stroke.
And we are back. I am your co-host, Samantha Cardwell, here with Stan Watson, my host, my
Tonight.
And our next guest is Alex Dobronovich-Chekskowinski.
Ooh, that was great.
She is also known as Alex D, and we're glad to have her here on the show. Welcome.
But we got to let her say her name, though. I mean, that was good. That was awesome. We practiced all offset for that, so pronounce it for us.
My last name?
Yes, please.
Dobronovich-Chekskowinski.
That's what we said. I like that.
Yeah,
that's exactly what we said.
Exactly.
You did a great job. Wonderful.
She's here with the New Georgia Project, mm-hmm. and so tell us what you do there with the New Georgia Project.
Sure, I'm the Director of Public Relations and External Affairs, mm-hmm. and the New Georgia Project is a nonprofit, nonpartisan organization. We're a civic engagement group. Mm-hmm. We meet folks where they are in the civic engagement process. We register, engage, and advocate for the underrepresented folks mm-hmm. in Georgia. We want folks to get registered to vote and exercise their right to vote.
Oh, wow, that's amazing.
The Georgia Project.
Awesome,
okay.
How old is the project?
We've been around a little over a year,
okay.
And ran a very large voter registration drive last year. Got a lot of folks registered with the help of many of our partners, the NAACP, the People's Agenda,
and a lot
of folks here in Atlanta.
Yeah.
That's the new, right? Right.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, as you progress, will you take out the new and you just be the Georgia Project?
I think that we will continue to do lots of new and innovative things.
Yeah.
So I think our name will stick around for a while.
Awesome.
Yeah.
That is great.
Talk about the mechanics of registering people to vote again, having civic engagement.
Yeah, well, we know that education is a huge part of that, mm-hmm. and so we do a lot of educating. We do a lot of workshops. We talk to people about, why they're not registered to vote and try to compel them to vote.
You got to hold that point out. Why, when you talk to people, why do they tell you they're not registered to vote?
Yeah.
Well,
somebody give us a good one.
Yeah. Yeah.
We've done a lot of research in that mm-hmm. area, and I think there's been a myth around mm-hmm. folks not registering to vote, particularly mm-hmm. people of color, that there's mm-hmm. been a lot of apathy.
Yes.
And what we have learned is it's not an apathetic behavior at all.
Mm-hmm.
There are a lot of barriers to registering to vote. Some people have social, economic barriers. Some people even have physical barriers. They're unable to get to the polls.
Yeah.
But a lot of people, it's a cycle, and they're not always they're not always sure why they should be voting or who they should be voting for.
Right.
Sometimes information is hard to get.
Mm-hmm.
And so we are trying to help in that area. One of the things we recently did was a civic engagement hackathon
mm-hmm.
to help out, hoping to get some tools from some of the tech community to
mm-hmm.
help people start getting more connected to tools that can help them vote.
Sure. Okay. And it's funny you should say that because we probably, folks that do vote
mm-hmm.
and folks that have access to voting materials probably take that for granted. I mean, we have access to television and radio
exactly.
and all of the different things.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're in a socioeconomic background where you don't readily have those things available, what is your motivation to go out maybe seek those types of things?
Absolutely, because even those of us who do, sometimes we find that there's a lot going on.
Sometimes
we don't even know who's everyone who's running for office, what they stand for, what their voting record is.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's information we can get into the hands of lots of folks, but particularly for people who are not registered to vote, we really want them to get registered and start thinking about exercising their voice.
So how do people accept you? You say you're nonpartisan, and you go out and try to get people registered to vote. You said there were some impediments for registering people to vote
mm-hmm.
or people registering to vote themselves. Is it places like the voter ID or suppression because we don't have driver license places where people mm-hmm. can get special IDs to make it work? I mean, what are some of the impediments you may have?
Absolutely. That's a great question
mm-hmm.
because we know a lot about the Voter Rights Act,
mm-hmm.
VRA,
mm-hmm.
lots going on in that area now. And some people do not have access to some of the things that are required to vote.
Mm-hmm.
If we are saying that people have a right to vote, we're going to have to figure out ways for folks who can't maybe afford to get an ID,
mm-hmm.
then what are they able to do?
Mm-hmm.
Here in the state of Georgia, people are able to vote, to register to vote with the last four digits of their social security numbers, yes. and a lot of people don't know that. Mm-hmm. So that's part of the education process, okay. too, and we're trying to help people learn that.
It's getting a little easier. I mean, it used to be that you could bring one of your utility bills down, and you could
really?
You could actually vote, you know.
I did not know that.
They took that away with the voter ID. That's all way.
Wow.
Well, some of the techies that we engaged for our hackathon, mm-hmm. They were coming up with a lot of very creative, innovative ways that could potentially be developed so that people had better access to the polls. So mm-hmm. things from, you know, text alerts. We know that most people now, no matter their social or economic background, oftentimes have mobile devices. Yes. So, you know, maybe a way for us to text people, to reach out to them where they are. Mm-hmm. Maybe even applications where people can get a ride to the polls, sort of like an Uber to voting, right?
Right.
Free rides to the polls to vote, where transportation would not be an issue. Yeah.
Awesome. Now, the hackathon, mm-hmm. tell us a little bit more about how that particular mechanism was used, and I'm sure this is, this being the first year, mm-hmm. How you might build upon that, some things that worked mm-hmm. and some things that maybe didn't work.
Sure. I'm glad you mentioned that it was our first year, and it was, and, and we believe it was the first of its type in the state of Georgia, the Civic Engagement Hackathon, where we're really focused on applications to help people have better access to the polls. But we found that we brought in more than just hackers, more than just the techies. Mm-hmm. We brought in civil rights advocates and disenfranchised voters to tell their stories, and we brought them all together mm-hmm. so that they could intersect their skill sets, really talk about their experiences, so that then the technological experts could apply that knowledge mm-hmm. into the applications they were trying to develop.
That's awesome as well.
Wow.
You said disenfranchised voters, mm-hmm. so are you talking about the persons that may come out of prison, or they may have a problem because they're a felon and they don't have, you know, the ability to vote, or are you talking about students coming out of high school? I mean, tell me a little bit about that.
All different types of voters. So for instance, we had a young lady, a college student, mm-hmm. who came to a hackathon and spoke about her experience at the polls. So a common issue is that college students go away to college. Mm-hmm. Even when they stay in the state, their permanent address was a home address, and now they have a college address.
Sure.
She showed up at the polls mm-hmm. and was told that she was not registered to vote, and she believed she was registered to vote. Mm-hmm. So she was a tenacious girl, and so she had to, you know, she had to call for reinforcements to say, hey, I believe I'm registered to vote. I think I have a right to vote. Mm-hmm. And she was eventually allowed to vote. So it's folks who are turned away and don't know what to do, mm-hmm. folks who believe they've registered and maybe they don't show up on the rolls. Mm-hmm. So those are the types of folks that we're really trying to reach.
That sounds great. Now you have another project coming up, a civic engagement, and it's called what again? Was it hackathon?
It was
They've had the hackathon.
So the new one is called the Pathathon. What do you call it?
Nope, that was the hackathon.
So what's your new civic engagement? Do you have another one?
They're just ongoing. So you know, we're always talking to voters. We're always talking to potential voters, and doing whatever we can. We're working with partners. Mm-hmm. Oftentimes, they will have other workshops and events going on, and we will partner with them to reach out to potential voters.
Well, I have to ask you this now. What have you heard? I mean, we started with these voting machines a couple mm-hmm. years ago. What have you heard from people you're trying to register to vote, or people that are coming back to vote, may have been dropped off the roll? What are you hearing about the voting machines today?
Well, what we know is that any voting machine can be an intimidating tool mm-hmm. for a lot of people. Mm-hmm. And our research shows us that some people avoid the polls because they don't know what to expect in there. They don't know if they're going to have to pull a lever or if they're going to have to push a button or if they're going to have to fill out a form. And so they stay away because they don't know. And a lot of our partners, and we're working with them, we actually go out to different events mm-hmm. and show folks what it really looks like so that when they walk up
so
to
take
a poll,
the machine out as well.
Absolutely.
Uh-huh.
They know
good.
Exactly what to expect.
Awesome.
Wow.
That's a lot to do
that's
as well.
Powerful.
So you've been doing this for a year.
We have.
And so are you grant funded, or how do you fund what you do?
Yes, we have a variety of funders, some private funders, and they believe in the work we do.
Yes.
Our work continues because there's a lot of work to do. There's still 700,000 people of color in the state of Georgia who are not registered to vote.
Come on, don't tell me that.
They need to register to vote. You've got to be registered to vote.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, that's wonderful, a lot of numbers.
Well, you do a lot of work, I mean, with this New Georgia Project. I think it's a great thing to do. Now, how do you educate them about the issues? You mentioned in your opening statement that you try to make sure you look at people's voting records. So how do you educate people about particular candidates or incumbents' voting record?
Yeah, we try to encourage folks to, log on to the internet, to go to different sites to, find out about folks who are voting. That's part of the hackathon. Mm-hmm. We have developed some things, and some things are going to be forthcoming. Maybe I'll come back and talk to you again about those, but some things are going to be coming out. They're going to be funded so that we can start letting people know a little bit in advance what's happening in their area, who's running for office, and what they've been talking about before they're running for office. Yeah.
Wow, good platform.
Very, very, the New Georgia Project. Now, where are you located?
We're downtown in the Little Five Points area. Okay. Yeah, but we get around. We cover the entire state, so we're always out and about.
Excellent, excellent. Well, before we let you go, you have to tell us how we can get in touch with you, or our viewing audience can get in touch with you if they'd like to find out more and maybe sponsor you to come out to their event.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. They should log on to newgeorgiaproject.org. That's the newgeorgiaproject.org. And come on, you can send us a message and let us know what you need, and we will respond to you.
Excellent.
Awesome. Well, our guest tonight has been Alex Dobronovichevsky.
That's okay. Dobronovichevsky.
Yes,
that's what she said.
Alex D. Here, the Director of Public Relations and External Affairs for the New Georgia Projects, giving us a lot of great information about what they're doing to help encourage people to come out and vote. And you can support her at the website that she's given. You can also give her a call. May I give this number out?
Absolutely.
As well? At 770-639-0256. We'll be right back after this break with more exciting guests right here on the Stan Watson Show.
I'm DeKalb County Sheriff Jeff Mann, reminding young people that any season is a great time to become more involved with others, to make new friends, and to have new positive experiences. Opportunities are everywhere, at community centers, boys and girls clubs, the Y, faith-based organizations, and local nonprofits. There, you can volunteer your assistance, and in the process, learn new things and meet new people. Or you can join a gang where all they want to do is break the law or harm other people and take their property. Gangs are not an option for social interaction or support. Take time to associate with groups that will lead to a promising future, one that will not end up here in the DeKalb County Jail. I'm DeKalb Sheriff Jeff Mann, and your safety is my priority.
You say you'd give your right arm to be there for your family? Here's your chance to prove it. Have your blood pressure checked and control it to lower your risk of heart attack and stroke.
Son drinking said, try Al-Anon family groups. Are you troubled by someone else's drinking? You might be surprised at what you could learn in an Al-Anon family group from people just like you. Call 1-888-4-ALANON or go to Al-Anon.
I don't want another drinking man in my life. I want to feel more fulfilled. Does my happiness depend on whether someone else drinks? My pastor suggested I try Al-Anon family groups, and I'm glad I did. Are you troubled by someone else's drinking? You might be surprised at what you could learn in an Al-Anon family group from people just like you. Call 1-888-4-Al-Anon or go to alanon.org.
He said he would, so darling, dry your eyes. So many other guys would give the world, I'm sure, to wear the shoes he wore. Oh, come on. Smile a little smile for me.
And we're back. Thank you again for tuning in to the Stan Watson Show. I'm your host, Stan Watson. Samantha, you did such a wonderful job with that last segment. I'm glad you introduced her. It was very interesting about what she's doing with the voter projects and things like that.
Very interesting.
Excellent. Very, very engaging. I hope to get her back and make sure what she's doing is felt in the community, because she talked a lot about civic engagement.
Yes.
I want to announce also that on November the 14th, we'll be having our cleanup at Tucker High School again. We'll be cleaning up the Tucker business area, the Tucker Civic Association. We got some great partners coming in from the Sheriff's Department. We also have some recycling efforts from the Keep the Cab Beautiful. So we'll be doing a lot of work on November the 14th over at Tucker High School. Starts at 9 a.m. in the morning. So come by and give me a hand. We're going to roll up our sleeves and clean up the area around La Vista, the Tucker Business Association area, and the Lawrenceville Highway area. So we'll make it work. That is, again, November the 14th. And again, if you need anything from our office, you can always call us at 404-371-3681. Well,
awesome.
You ready to go back to work?
I am ready.
Okay.
You know, our next guest is Darren Gale. He is the owner of the Georgia Gifts and More.
And More.
Yeah.
Yes.
Hey, Darren. More.
Gifts and More.
Gifts and More. Gifts
and
hey, Darren.
More. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
We're doing wonderful.
Good,
wonderful.
Where are you from, Darren?
Believe it or not, I'm originally from Savannah, Georgia.
Oh, that's great.
Wow,
Savannah,
that's
Georgia.
Cool place.
Savannah, Georgia.
So how long have you been in Atlanta?
In Atlanta since 1990.
Oh, so yeah, you're
so I'm the,
yeah, you're right.
Basically from here now.
Yeah, forever. Yeah. Okay, what brought you to Atlanta?
Entertainment, okay.
opportunity
to grow business.
Okay.
Awesome. Well, great. Awesome. Yes. Tell us about what you have going on. You're the owner of Georgia Gifts and More. What is Georgia Gifts and More?
Well, actually, I can't take full credit.
Okay.
It's actually me and my wife.
Okay.
I was going to say, you
he's
better
a
be
smart
sharp.
Guy. He's a smart guy. Okay,
that you want to go home.
Okay.
Yes.
You're part owner. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm part owner. But primarily what Georgia Gifts is, we are a company which we specialize in Georgia themed items.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Since Georgia is such a wonderful place to live and as we say, a peachy place to be.
Peachy place to be, okay.
We specialize in gift baskets, gift items, be it Georgia peanuts, Georgia peach jelly beans, Coca-Cola products.
So you're
Georgia
Bulldogs. Georgia stuff sounds
all
like
Georgia.
All Georgia.
Georgia.
Georgia. Georgia so far. So Georgia things.
Everything Georgia, because Georgia, the state of Georgia, is a wonderful tourist market.
Sure.
And people from all over the world come to Georgia and they want to take things back to where they live from Georgia,
from
or they
Georgia.
May want to send things to Georgia, from Georgia to their family members in other areas.
Excellent. Okay.
So now, who do you work with in terms of wholesale access to the things? Because some of the things I'm sure you don't make yourself, you have access.
Well, actually,
you mentioned Coca-Cola, for example.
Well, actually,
Coca-Cola
and the peanuts too. And the peanuts too. All right.
Yeah, yeah. Well, actually, we do have a host of vendors that we work with. But also, again, there are a lot of the products that we carry, we actually manufacture ourselves.
Oh, wow.
Really?
So you do that?
Yes.
Then.
Yes.
Oh, that's
so
great.
You have a building where you have your manufacturing?
We actually have a showroom.
Okay, showroom.
Located 3781. Presidential Parkway, which is near the Green Egg, across the street from the Green Egg.
So the Green Egg, is that near 85?
That's right, 85, right off the highway.
Yeah, gotcha, okay.
We're right at the Shambly-Tucker Road exit.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you're just about in my district by that much, okay. How long have you been there?
We've been there now for a year.
Okay. Well, to follow up on Samantha's question, what are some of the products you make, and what are some of the products? You told me earlier that something about jelly beans?
The jelly beans, for an example.
Yeah, Samantha and I eat these after.
Okay.
We're going to figure out.
We'll
probably let the staff taste one or two.
Okay.
But okay, tell us about
these. Now, the great thing about those jelly beans is we have a relationship with Hilton Hotels right now.
Yes.
And they have something called the Hilton Honors Program.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Now, in about 75 of the Hampton Inn hotels in the state of Georgia, they carry our Georgia Peach jelly beans.
Really?
What?
So, if you go in.
So instead of the mint under the pillow, I can look for a jelly bean. Is that what you're saying?
Well, you can look for a jelly bean.
Kidding. Okay. Yeah. All right.
You can look for a jelly bean, you can look for our Georgia Peach gummies, or you can look for our Georgia peanuts.
Oh,
so when you go into the Hampton Inn, you'll see something that says sweet statements.
Sweet statements.
That's our line.
Oh
wow. Now, how did you come up with this? I mean, were you guys, before you did this, bakers, natural bakers? Were you already in
candy makers,
the hospitality business?
Well, how it started, my wife actually had a gift basket business.
Mm-hmm.
In Stone Mountain, Georgia.
Okay, Stone Mountain. Mm-hmm.
For about 14 years.
Mm-hmm.
And my background is marketing, promotions, tour management. Because I come from an entertainment background.
This is a match made in heaven.
Coming together now. So y'all dates were eventful, right?
Yes. So she pretty much designs and does the back office stuff, and I'm more like the face.
The front man.
The face.
Well, you're the front guy. Okay.
And believe it or not, my name is Darren. Her name is Karen.
Oh, come on, Darren. Come on. Come on. Talk about that. Talk about your gift baskets. And is this one of the sizes? Tell us about
that. That's actually one of the sizes.
Okay.
And that carries our Grits Bits, which is actually.
Say that one more time.
Grits Bits.
Grits Bits.
Which is actually cookies.
That's Georgia, too.
Grits Bits. Made out of grits.
That's definitely Georgia.
With a Vidalia onion flavor.
Hello, okay. With what? Say it again?
It's cookies made out of grits
with
a Vidalia onion flavor.
Okay, all right.
Which is Georgia.
Like biscuits.
Yes.
Okay, all right, that's wonderful.
Yes.
Excellent. And now what size is this? I mean, apparently they come in different
sizes. Yeah, that's one of our smaller sizes.
Okay.
But we have small, medium, and large sizes.
Okay. Yes. So who are some of the people that you have dealt with that are celebrities? I mean, it seems like it's a great thing.
Well,
I mean, I got the smaller version. I'm on the big version.
Okay.
You know, you got a cast of people coming in.
Oh, yeah. We do a lot of movies. We've done stuff with Tyler Perry. We've done recently The Little Women, the reality show.
Yeah.
Okay.
They recently purchased some stuff from us.
Okay.
I mean, we have a lot of clients that are, you know, when they first come to the area, again, they want Georgia stuff. They want to welcome their clients and give them Georgia-type items.
So the film industry has been a great client for you.
A wonderful client.
I figured that, okay.
Wonderful client. And sometimes you may see our stuff on the set.
I'm going to look for it. I'm going to look for
that
it now.
Really remarkable. Cool. That's really cool.
Mm, excellent. So now how do you come up with the gift basket? You base it on personality of the person, or they kind of tell you what they want in the basket?
Primarily what happens is we have a website.
Okay.
Which is www.georgiagiftsandmore.com.
Okay, make sure you get that again before you leave, but go ahead right here.
And what happens is a lot of our clients that go to our website, they see, you know, the items that we have available on the website.
Mm-hmm.
And we also have gift baskets that are already made, so pre-made gift baskets.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So we can custom design the gift basket, or you can actually choose one.
We'll put it together.
We can put together. Also, clients like Fox Theater, for instance, may come in and they may put some of their Fox Theater products inside the basket.
Yes.
So if they're sending it that's to a client in another market,
sure.
You know, from Georgia.
From Georgia.
Yeah.
You have that Georgia flavor along with your company's logo and your company's product inside of it.
I am impressed.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now, how big is your staff?
We have three every day.
Every day, okay.
And we have about six kind of part-time. So when we get the large orders that come in, they come in and we work it out.
Now, what would you tell a person trying to get in a business like this or similar, how you got started? What were some of the things you may tell them to be successful that you guys may have had a slip here or there to make it work?
Well, one thing about gift baskets, everybody can make.
That was something.
Everybody can't make them.
Everybody can't make them. Okay.
And just to give you an example, I was at an event last year, mm-hmm. and our company was there, and there was another young lady next to us, and she had a few baskets. Mm-hmm. And she was like, look at my basket, but look at yours,
yeah.
You know? So it's an art to it.
Right.
Your wife does most of it? Yeah, my wife. She pretty much does. I'm learning how to do it, but my wife does it.
Yeah.
It's an art to it, but also you got to do your research.
Yeah.
You're not going to find grits bits just anyway. You know what I'm saying?
Never seen that.
So you got to do your research. You have to know your target market because everybody's not going to buy it.
Right.
And for us, again, it's been such a success and a blessing for us is we found the niche.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you got to find your niche because you'll see 100 gift baskets everywhere.
Right.
But you won't see a Georgia basket everywhere.
No, this is really a Georgia basket.
Neat.
Yeah.
So are you a one-stop shop? Do people call you not only for the baskets, maybe say, I'm in town, I need a limo or something? Or
oh, we have access to that. Now, also, we're not just gift baskets.
Right.
We also have a part where we do family reunions.
Really?
So
plan them and
we do family reunions where you have people come in again, other areas. They want welcome bags. They want gift bags.
Yes, yes.
They want the items that go inside the bags.
Mm-hmm.
They want the T-shirts. They want the water bottles. Want the hats.
Hospitality.
He had it together.
So it's all there.
An event planning almost. Mm-hmm.
Of course.
Well, Well, Darren, before we let you go, look over here and tell us how we can get in contact with you, your website and phone number, because I think people want to know about Georgia Gifts and More.
Okay. Well, for Georgia Gifts and More, we are 3781 Presidential Parkway, Suite 137. That's Atlanta, Georgia, 30340. Phone number is 404-241-1375. Our website is www.georgiagiftsandmore.com.
Excellent. Well, I got to share this one more time.
Well,
you want to share this, right?
I do want to share it.
I might give it to you. I don't know.
Let Darren go.
Yeah.
Because we want Darren to get home safely.
Right.
We want Darren to mention his wife's name. I don't think he said
it. He said Karen.
Did he say Karen?
Yeah, but he said
we
it again.
We want to say it
attention.
Again. Karen and Darren.
Karen and Darren Gale.
You got to wait way better now. Way better.
Hey, Karen.
Well, all those stuff. Okay, we call for gift
right, Karen.
No, you were
right,
saying I want to share it. You didn't say my name. So we'll make it work. Well, Darren, thank you so much for coming by.
That's a great basket.
Excellent, and we'll make sure that you get back, and maybe we'll do some business with you to make sure that you're doing what you're supposed to do. Like
the Georgia Gifts.
But you know what he said? You won't find another basket like this.
No,
that's unique.
Great. Our guest has been Mr. Darren Gale, along with his wife, who's also an owner, Karen Gale, and they're the owners of Georgia Gifts and More right here in Atlanta, Georgia. Thank you so much for watching Stan Watch the Show. We'll take a quick break. You want to come back?
We'll be back with a musical.
Yeah, with a musical.
Yes, Vanda Ray's coming up.
Oh, okay. Well, wonderful. We'll make sure we announce it then. Stay right there. We'll be right back.
County has a new smart way to help keep you safe. Seconds count when a child goes missing, there's a fire, you experience a medical emergency, or have an accident, and seconds save lives. Smart 911 is a free service that allows citizens to create a safety profile with information they want to share with 911.
At a time when seconds count, and you may be panicked or unable to communicate, Smart 911 can help relay important information the second an emergency call is placed. It could be the difference between life and death.
When anyone dials from a phone associated with a specific Smart 911 profile, those additional important details are immediately displayed to the 911 call taker. That helps ensure the proper response to the proper location.
Give 911 the extra information it needs to better help you and your family in the event of an emergency. Let's keep our community smart about safety. Sign up for Smart 911 today.
log on to www.smart911.com for more information.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life.
Here I come.
Take time to be a dad today.
Daddy, I'm gonna find you.
Save the Bears. Sign the petition. Go to helpbears.org.
He said he would, so darling, dry your eyes.
And welcome back to the Stan Watson Show. I'm your host, Stan Watson, along with our lovely co-host, Samantha Caldwell. We've had a great show tonight. Some great, great guests. The first one was our DeKalb Solicitor General, Sherry Boston. And supposedly she's very busy. She's doing a, what she called a Create a Safer DeKalb essay program for our eighth graders, we're middle school kids all across DeKalb County.
That's right.
And she said it will start in a couple of weeks, so look out for that. She's doing a great job with that. And she said if it's 400 essays, that she would take the time and read everyone.
I know, that's a lot of essays.
I hope she doesn't call me. Stan, we need you to come over to the Solicitor General's office.
Great prizes, too. No, she said a tablets. They're
giving away tablets. Mm-hmm. And then the other one, that you actually did a great job in pronouncing the last name.
Alex Dobrowinski.
Ski, okay, great. And she is Director of Public Relations for the New Georgia Project.
Yes.
And she does a lot and did a lot, she said, with the voter registration, civic engagement, and those kind of things. And so she does a great job. Hopefully I get her back and see what she's doing closer to the elections. It's coming up in March and May, and then again in November here in Georgia and across the country. I thought
that's
that was awesome.
Nonpartisan and everything.
And she said she was born in Spain.
I know, that was pretty interesting.
Yeah, I can see the name, okay, right. And then our last guest, Darren, did such a great job.
Yeah.
Owner of the Georgia Gifts and More right here in DeKalb County, a great opportunity for you to look at some of the things on his website that he gave you, and I think that was great.
Awesome. Well, our next guest will be with us in the musical studio, and that is Vanda Ray. So we're going to allow her to take it away with great music. Next.
We give you the glory, we give you the honor, we bless your name, O Lamb of God. We give you the glory, we give you the honor, we bless his name, O Lamb of God. We lift you higher. Yes, we do, Jesus. We bless your name, O Lamb of God. We lift you higher. The mountains, we bless your name, O Lamb of God. God, we give you all the honor. Oh, we lift and hands, we praise your name, Lord. O Lamb of God. Oh, Hallelujah, Jesus. To you be the glory, and to you be of the honor, to you be the praise, all ever, God, yeah. Oh Lord, when I think about everything I went through, Lord, only you deserve the glory, Jesus. I think about the goodness and all that Jesus done for me. How you went on the cross. Yes, he did. Hallelujah. He did it so that we could be set free. Oh, and I bless his name. He's awesome. He's the best person. The best person that I desire to be like. Oh, Lamb of God. Oh, Hallelujah, Jesus. He's an awesome God. Bless his holy name. Praise God.
Hello, I'm DeKalb County Interim CEO Lee May, and I'm excited to announce after a successful test run, we are rolling forward to one. It's one of the biggest service delivery changes in our county's history, all to better serve you.
Starting July 6th, DeKalb's implementing a one-day-a-week service model for collecting your garbage, recycling, and yard trimmings. We are rolling forward with the times to reduce inefficiencies, keep costs low, and improve safety. It's a change for the county, but a necessary one. The new program offers many benefits with absolutely no increase in fees to you. The county will provide standardized 65-gallon green trash containers, which will create a streamlined look of uniformity in your neighborhood. You'll place your solid waste, recycling, and yard trimmings at the curb all on the same day now. That's once a week. Rolling forward to one also includes an increased focus on recycling education and litter reduction, falling right in line with DeKalb's many green initiatives. This new program is expected to save the county between $8 to $10 million annually. Part of those savings will come from lower costs for equipment, maintenance, and resources. Also, no sanitation division employees will be terminated as a result of this service level change. Some employees will be redeployed to serve in varying roles with the division's Clean Communities Initiative, thereby keeping our communities even cleaner than ever before. If you have any questions about the new sanitation collection procedures, contact customer service at 404-294-2900 or go online to rollingforwardto1.com.
So, get ready for Rolling Forward to One as this new program saves time, money, and resources. DeKalb County, it's time to roll, and we are doing it together as one.
It's not the way you smile.
Summer is finally here, and you may be planning to go away on vacation. I'm DeKalb County Sheriff Jeff Mann, reminding you that you can leave your home without worrying. Here's how. First, only let your closest relatives or acquaintances know you are leaving and when you'll return. If possible, have someone you trust pick up your mail and newspapers. By all means, do not advertise your vacation on social media. Put inside and outside lights on timers so that your property continues to appear occupied. Finally, if you don't have an alarm system, consider having one installed. But make sure it's monitored so police and fire can be called. Then, enjoy your time with your family and friends. You deserve it. I'm DeKalb Sheriff Jeff Mann, and your safety is my priority.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
All right, remember that we'll see you next week. Well, we won't see you next week. We'll have another show the following week because of Veterans Day. And so we're going to make sure that we give a shout out to our veterans across the United States, especially here in DeKalb County. We have a special show for you, probably the best of Stan Watson.
Yeah,
and don't forget me, on November the 14th, we'll be cleaning up around the Tucker area.
That's right.
And we'll make sure we look that. I've had a great time. You have a great time?
I have had a wonderful time.
Well, they tell me that's all the time we've got. So guess what? We'll see you next week.
See you next time.